This is Gerard Welbrock inviting you to join us for Tiger Talk. Catch the video replay of Monday night's radio program at 10:30 and 7 o'clock Tuesdays and Wednesdays on Eagle Cable Channel 14 and 614. That's Tiger Talk, Mondays on Tiger Radio Mix 103 and Tuesdays and Wednesdays at 10:30 and 7 on Eagle Cable Channel 14 and 614. Hello again, everyone, and welcome into another edition of Tiger Talk. Gerard Welbrock with you, as we'll be joined by head football coach Chris Brown momentarily. Another nail-biter that literally came down to the final play on Saturday. Unfortunately, didn't quite go the Tigers' way as they fall 26-21 at Missouri Western to drop to 4-2 on the year. Tigers back at home this Saturday afternoon. Another big one against the undefeated Emporia State Hornets, who are now 6-0 after rallying to beat Pittsburgh State at Welt Stadium this past Saturday. So it should be another fun one at Lewis Field, and we'll talk all about that a little bit later. And first, we'll recap the exciting but disappointing game at Missouri Western. Tiger Talk presented by the Golden Corral Buffet and Grill. They're just north of the interstate in Hayes, open 7 days a week. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll catch up with head coach Chris Brown right after this. Welcome back to Tiger Talk. Gerard Welbrock, head football coach Chris Brown joining us now as the Tigers trying to rebound from another difficult loss, 26-21 at Missouri Western on Saturday afternoon. And, well, coach, another exciting game. Came down to the final play this time. Evan Jennings just couldn't quite make that play in the back of the end zone, but it was sure thrilling, and you guys had a great chance.
It was. You know, we didn't come out and play real well the second half, gave up a couple big plays. Had an assignment bust on defense too, you know, man coverage wise, and that gave him, you know, an easy touchdown as well. But I feel like we gave him two easy touchdowns. You know, those are things we got to eliminate. But, you know, we gave ourselves a chance to win that ball game. Just came up short, and you know. But the thing about our kids is they kept battling, they kept fighting, they kept working and believing in what we're doing, and you know, they just trusted in the system and the things that we were doing. And you know, these kids are resilient. They're going to fight back and battle back, and hopefully get better this week.
I know you were upset. A lot of folks are upset. A lot of contact on that last play, but I thought you said it well in the post-game show. Yes, that was key, but you also had some missed opportunities, which could have changed things dramatically and not come down to the final play.
Yeah, there's two situations. You know, we blocked the field goal. You know, we got to go down and score there. Create a turnover, you know, and another opportunity for us to go score, and I don't think we got points off either one of those. And, you know, that's hard, you know, on a defense, and it's hard on the team when you don't capitalize on those situations. But, you know, we have to take advantage of those things, and we have to make things happen, and we have to get some more, you know, first downs and not just go three and out and make a few more plays. You know, when you look at that film, it's just, you know, the throw was just a little bit off, or one block wasn't hit, or the back didn't hit the hole like he was supposed to. And, you know, we probably score another 14, 21 points. But, you know, we got to get things cleaned up, and, we just got to come out more physical than we did in that game.
You mentioned the first half was a bit of a struggle. This felt like just could not quite get in sync. He had the big run early on, but other than that, it was a struggle to get anything rolling in that first half.
It is. You know, I kind of feel like sometimes when I watch film and see the things that we're doing, that we really rely on the big play quite a bit. You never really see us sustain a drive and, you know, go down the field and take a 4 or 5 minute drive and score points. It's always a big play that gets us there. We just need to learn how to sustain drives, get first downs and take some time off the clock and, you know, with all the injuries that we've had and things going on, I'm really proud of our kids that have stepped up and, you know, gave us the opportunity to win that ball game. But, you know, we got to do a better job of controlling the clock and getting more points on the board.
And I guess that is a good point. You've gone through a lot this year with player after player seemingly going down. But yet, despite all that, you're right there against some of these upper echelon teams. And as you said, had a chance to win it going into that final possession and darn near pulled it off. It is quite remarkable. These guys are pretty resilient, aren't they?
They are. They're a great group of kids. You know, it's, you know, we tell them all the time, be prepared to play at any time. And you never know when your number is going to get called. And so they practice like that. They're in tune during practice and meetings. They're focused in and locked in. And, you know, with the way things have gone this season, who knows who's up next. And but our kids have done a great job of filling in and preparing themselves to play on the football field and to make plays for us and then just getting the job done. And that's what our kids are doing right now.
A couple of guys defensively, Brock Long, he's been playing banged up, and he continues to be remarkable. I mean, he was bringing it. He was physical in that ball game and played outstanding.
He has. You know, he's really stepped up his game, you know, since Schmidtberger and Delgado went down. And, you know, McPhail, he's really turned into a totally different player, has really taken ownership on the football field. But just the way he plays the game is the way it's supposed to be played. I mean, nothing dirty. He's just playing fast. He's playing physical. He's being aggressive. And he's making some, you know, very solid tackles. And he knows how to take on blocks as well. And, you know, if we get every kid playing like that, you know, we're going to be very, very successful.
Another kid, Doyen Jabobo, just a redshirt freshman, had probably his best game. Very well-spoken young man. It's been really nice to get to know him a little bit. And maybe had his best game as a Tiger for just a young guy.
He did, except for his very first play. Well, and I was a little upset with him on that. We just talked about it. But, you know, he learned from it. And you know, I don't think it happened to him the rest of the game. But, you know, he's a kid that's a competitor. He wants to get better each week. And, you know, he's still learning the defense and exactly where he fits in, you know, on certain schemes and where he's supposed to be. But, you know, as he goes along, he's getting better. But, you know, he is a very, very good kid, very well-spoken. He's just one of those kids that you're proud to have on your team because you know he's going to do the right thing and he's going to work his tail off for you.
Well, unfortunately, not enough to pull out the victory. We'll talk a little bit more detailed about the game at Missouri Western when we return. Tigers fall 26-21, and we'll relive it, if you will, here coming up after the break. Tiger Talk, of course, presented by the Golden Corral Buffet and Grill just north of the interstate in Hayes. And going on right now, for just $1.99 when you buy a regular meal, you get your to-go box. It's almost like two meals in one at the Golden Corral, best buffet in the USA. More Tiger Talk right after this.
They're growing up and getting busier. Between school, sports, dance, sleepovers, you want to make sure they can always reach you when they need to. Nextech Wireless has the perfect cell phone starter plan. For only $40 per month, it includes unlimited data, calling, and texting. There are no contracts or overages, so they can call, text, YouTube, and stream all they want. Plus, smartphones start at just $150. Certain restrictions apply. Get the $40 WOW unlimited plan at Nextech Wireless.
Welcome back to Tiger Talk. Gerard Welbrock, head coach Chris Brown. The program brought to you by the Golden Corral Buffet and Grill, where kids eat free every Tuesday from 4 until close. Four-day State falling 26-21 at Missouri Western Saturday. And you mentioned it, gave up a couple of big plays early, but I thought the defense settled down, regrouped, held them to a field goal that was very close to being a miss, but after giving up a couple of big plays, did a nice job of holding them to three.
They did. You know, we did a good job defensively. I mean, if you just take away those two plays, I mean, it's, you know, a totally different ball game. You know, by we're playing a deep thirds coverage, you know, you just man turned instead of zone turned and didn't keep the receiver, you know, in front of him and got beat. And then, you know, Dumas on the next play, it was, you know, man-to-man coverage, guy motioned across, needed to pick up the tight end, thought the tight end blocked, but he was actually dragging across and left him wide open. So, you know, you take away those two mistakes, you know, we win that ball game. But holding them to field goals is very important. And, you know, the one that really gets me is the one right before half. I just wish we could have ran the clock out offensively and not gave him that opportunity because now, you know, we're within striking distance. And, you know, with the way the game ended up, you know, we're kicking a field goal to win the ball game instead of trying to go for a touchdown.
They get the field goal. You come right back, though, and you talked about the big play. Shaquille Cooper, a 67-yard run to give you the lead, and obviously you felt a little bit better about things after that.
Yeah, we did. You know, we felt good about the things that were going on. Our kids were, you know, very enthusiastic and excited about the things happening on the field. You know, they believe, you know, that they can hang with any team in this conference, and, you know, they continue to believe in those things because, you know, we got a very good football team, and, you know, our kids are strong, they're athletic, they work hard and they're dedicated, and that's one thing I say about our kids, they are hardworking, they're going to play hard, you know, until the very last whistle, and, you know, we're close, you know, it's just a matter of getting a few breaks. If we get those few breaks, you know, we might be sitting here at 6-0 right now.
7-3 the game, came a defensive battle, changing of possessions, and then they break a big one, a 40-yard touchdown pass, and it seemed to maybe put you back on your heels a little bit after that play.
It did, you know, it's just one of those things that we really haven't given up a big play, you know, all year long, and that's something we really stressed in practice, and, you know, our kids have got to do, you know, a better job of keeping those things in front of us because it's something that we talk about all the time, you know, doing your job and making it important to do your job, and, you know, we just got beat, but that kind of hurts your back a little bit. Takes a little bit of momentum out of your hands, too, and gives it back to Mo West.
Their starter, Windmiller, you sacked him early. He never returned. T.J. LeFevre came in. Did that change anything? It seemed like he was able to run the ball maybe a little bit better than Windmiller does.
You know, but we've faced quarterbacks like that all year long, and you know, we're used to, you know, scrambling quarterbacks, quarterbacks that can run, quarterbacks can, that can extend plays, and you know, he's just another one of those kids. So it didn't really change our game plan much. I mean, every week we have to spy the quarterback and understand what they're doing and where they're at, and you know, I thought we did a good job of it. Just, you know, he broke contain a few times and scrambled for some first downs, but you know, we're used to that. You know, in this conference, you're going to have quarterbacks that can run, and it's just part of it.
They score 16 unanswered to close the half, and you kind of alluded to it a little bit ago. I thought a key stretch, you got the ball. It's 16-7, a quick three and out. I think you gained 6 yards on a pass completion, but then could not get the first down after that. They get it quickly, and then to their credit, they kick a career-long 51-yard field goal for their young field goal kicker. And as the game turned around and turned out, that ended up really being kind of the series of the ball game, you not able to convert and then setting them up for the field goal after a long punt return.
It is, and it's all about the game, you know. And, you know, still I think we come out and score a few more points, you know, offensively, but that's a huge part right there. You know, there's only like a minute 15 on the clock. Either go down and score, get some first downs, run the clock out one way or another. But, you know, we're trying to get points on the board to, you know, get within striking distance, you know, for after half because we get the ball back. But, you know, we didn't get the job done. They kick a – it was a great kick by their kicker, great protection by their guys up front. And, you know, hats off to him for getting those things done.
Well, going to the locker room, trailing 19-7, Fort A State kind of turns it around, puts together a good charge in the second half, and we'll talk all about it when we return. Tiger Talk presented by the Golden Corral Buffet and Grill, just north of the interstate, best buffet in the USA. We're back with more right after this.
BOS Motorsports in Hayes introduces the top off-road vehicle lineup with Polaris. The world leader in off-road innovation presents the Razor, Ranger, Sportsman, and Ace off-road vehicles right here in the heartland of BOS Motorsports in Hayes. Whether you're looking for something for the trail, the farm, the oil patch, the hunt, BOS has the ride just for you. Stop in today and ride away with yours. At BOS, customer service is number one. Our in-house parts and service department will take care of you before, during, and after the sale. BOS Motorsports, just north of I-70 at exit 159 in Hayes.
Back on Tiger Talk, presented by the Golden Corral, best buffet in the USA, open 7 days a week just north of the interstate in Hayes. And again, kids eat free every Tuesday from 4 until close. And a lot of great items from breakfast to dinner to steaks and seafood. They've got it all at the Golden Corral. Gerard Welbrock is joined by head coach Chris Brown. Tigers trailing at halftime. And boy, came out and got a good possession to start the second half. Got a big 46-yard run from Travion Aber, got you close, and he hit Shaquille Cooper on a 17-yard pass play, and bam, 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 you're right back in the ballgame.
Yeah, we were. You know, I just think we started the game, we were pretty flat. Then we came back out after half, had a good talk with them about the things that they needed to do and believed in themselves and the things, you know, that we're capable of. And, you know, our kids really came out firing all cylinders and made some things happen. But scoring on that first drive after half is very, very important for that football game because it really kind of changes the whole game and the things that are going on. But, you know, good for our kids for doing that. You know, they could have folded their tents, and that's something I'll talk to them about in the locker room. We're going to find out what type of team you are. You guys are going to be a group of team that – group of guys that fight back and battle, or are you going to be a group that quits? This is all about character right now, and let's see what your character is.
Well, they certainly showed some good character. You get the touchdown, then they drive, but you get a stop and you block another field goal. Your seventh block kick of the year, Daniel Lindsay's fourth. It's just phenomenal to watch what you guys do. But, boy, huge momentum turn. You felt really excited about what could unfold after that play.
It is, you know, and that's another opportunity for us. You know, we kept points off the board. You know, those guys off the edge do a good job. Our D-line up front gets a great push as well. And, you know, it puts a lot of stress on that field goal team or that PAT team. And, you know, they got to block and protect, but our guys are quick off the edge. Our D-line's getting a great push and getting their hands up. So, you know, I feel good every time those guys go out there because there's a potential to keep points off the board. And, you know, we did that. But that's a situation right there where we're in striking distance. I think if we go score there, I believe we take the lead. And now this is a whole totally different ballgame.
Yeah, kind of a swing. You block the field goal, three and out. They come back, get a touchdown, and now you're down 12 again.
Yeah, it is. And that's just, you know, over and over, it's the same story every week that we're doing right now. And, you know, our kids have got to find a ways to capitalize on opportunities given to them. And, you know, it's we can talk about it and preach about it and tell them, you know, everything that they need to do, but it really needs to come down to them just getting the job done and understanding what they got to do to get themselves, you know, in that situation and capitalize on those situations, because we can't do it for them. You know, it's a sense of urgency that they got to start having on their own and, you know, start taking some ownership in it and score some points.
To their credit, though, they get a stop, even though your next possession, you don't do anything with it. You stop them, get the ball, and then, again, Travion gets hits Andrew Florey for a big pass and then eventually is able to take it in, gets you back to within five with a lot of the fourth quarter still ahead of you.
Yeah, that was a great throw on his part. You know, he bought himself some time as well, and, you know, Andrew did a good job of getting himself open on the sideline, and it was a great catch by him of getting some spacing between him and the defender, and it was a good ball by Travion, putting it where it needed to be so the defender couldn't knock it down, but we needed that, and we needed those points right there in that situation, and we got them.
Next few possessions is probably where it gets frustrating, because you force a fumble, and they had only lost one fumble all year prior to that one. Luke Wright falls on it. You get the ball in great position. And again, three and out, unable to do anything with it. That was a great opportunity to take the lead back, and then who knows?
It is. You know, we're within striking distance, and we've got a great opportunity to go and take the lead. And, you know, we take the lead there. You know, it might break their backs a little bit. You know, our defense will be a little bit more fired up, probably hopefully get another three and out, and then get the ball back to our offense and maybe score again. So, I mean, that little series right there is a huge part of why we didn't win that ball game.
Got to stop, and then Travion throws an interception. Looked like he either didn't see the linebacker or somebody ran a wrong route. Do you know quite exactly what happened on that breakdown?
When I looked at it, it's his technique. You know, he had a guy coming to his face, and, you know, he's going to try to protect himself and kind of flipped his hips. And when he flipped his hips, his arm kind of followed through to the defender instead of where Garrett Holly was at. Because, you know, Holly was open. He was trying to throw it to Holly, but he just – you know, sometimes you got to take the hit, and that's just part of being a quarterback, and he's got to learn to do that. And, you know, you're going to take a shot here and there, and if he takes that shot and hits Holly, you know it's a first down.
Well, didn't happen, but again, the defense comes through, get a three and out, got the ball back, not much time. Andrew Florey goes down with a knee injury on the possession, but Evan Jennings stepped up, and you keep talking about next man up, and we've had to talk about that a lot, makes a huge 41-yard catch, gets you down inside to 10 to give you a chance.
It was. You know, he's ran his route. Travion scrambles, does what he's supposed to do in scramble drill, gets his hands up in the air. Travion sees him, makes a nice throw to him, and gets vertical. And, you know, I don't blame the kid at all for getting vertical, because you always want to see him get out of bounds and save some clock, but – I mean, there was a seam there. They just converted on it pretty quick, but he got the ball down to the seven. But that's a huge play by him, and that's a big play by him. And hopefully that gives him some confidence in, you know, going into these next few weeks, because we're going to need him to play for us.
And talk about the situation there. The clock stops after the first down, spiked the ball. So you have 15 seconds, and you still got three plays. It was close to an interception. They land out of bounds. You had one final tick left, and then obviously the controversial play at the very end. But a good job to give yourself three cracks at it, and three pretty good cracks at it in the end zone.
They were, you know, in the heck, all three of those plays, you know, who knows what you could have called. But, you know, back short throw to Max instead of trying to throw it to the corner, probably score. Evan Jennings is able to get up in the air and catch that ball. You know, he probably scores. And then the very first one, you know, he just made a bad throw, but it was probably close enough to catch if we just could have got to the back pylon. But, you know, gave ourselves a chance. Just didn't happen for us. And you know, hopefully our kids learn from this, start sooner, you know, and then learn how to finish. And, but, you know, we're going to keep battling, keep working, hopefully get a win this next week.
Well, it was a great game. Unfortunately, the Tigers come up on the wrong end of the scoreboard. And as Coach said, really can't worry about it now, because here comes undefeated Emporia State on Saturday. We're going to take our final break. We'll talk about the Hornets when we return. This is Tiger Talk.
At Eagle Communications, we're proud to provide the communication services you need to get the most from today's technology. Our employee owners make it happen. We're part of your community, and we take pride in delivering excellent customer service. If you ever have a question, give us a call. We're here to help. Eagle Communications, our community connected.
Welcome back. Our final segment here on Tiger Talk, presented by the Golden Corral. Call 625-4141 about catering. They've got a great catering service, so the next time you have a big company gathering, maybe a family outing or whatever, check out the catering from the Golden Corral, just north of the interstate in Hayes, best buffet in the USA. 4-2 Tigers back at home Saturday afternoon, 2 o'clock kick against undefeated Emporia State, 6-0, big comfort behind win for them over Pittsburgh State on Saturday. And I don't know where you start with him. I guess you start with their quarterback, Brent Wilson. He was hurt last year. They struggled. He's back this year. They're 6-0. He's pretty darn good, maybe as good as there is in the conference.
He's one of the best ones I've seen at quarterback. I mean, he's able to scramble. He sees things well. He's got a quick release with his arm. Can throw the ball deep as well and put it on the money. He's just a kid that buys himself time all the time. And, he's just very, very elusive. We're going to have to find a way to try to keep him contained in the pocket, not let him out, because when he's out running around, he makes things happen, and that's when they get a lot of their big plays, just because of his feet and things that he's doing. He's not a quarterback that looks to run, but he's a quarterback that when he's running, he's looking to throw it and make a big play, but if it's not there, he can scramble for, 20, 30, even 40 yards. He could even score. He's just a very elusive player and a very, very good football player.
Threw four touchdown passes Saturday against Pitt, 65 now in his career, an Emporia State record. I mean, 65, and considering he didn't play much last year because of injury, remarkable.
It is remarkable. It's just, you can tell you he's a very, very smart football player, and as the year goes on, he gets even smarter. Just the things that he does with the ball and understanding the situations, and he's not going to take a chance, and if he's scrambling around and he's going to get sacked and lose yards, he's going to throw that thing away, and he finds his check down receivers. If something's not there, he's going to be patient enough to go find that check down. And he doesn't force anything. He's just a very headsy, very smart football player. And, we got to find a way to keep him contained, keep him in the pocket, and hopefully fluster him a little bit and get some hits on him.
Deep receiving core for them. They've got a lot of guys with catches and multiple catches, and he does a good job of getting them all involved, it looks like.
He does. He just doesn't have that one guy that he likes to throw it to. He throws it to all of them. They're kind of funny in games because sometimes they're real quick, three-step, one-step. I mean, just getting the ball out of his hands, then the next thing they're going deep in another game. So, you got to kind of prepare yourself for both those aspects of the game defensively. But it all comes down to him. If we can contain him and get him rattled and kind of get him off his game, we could be successful.
Defensively, what kind of challenge do they pose?
They run the ball very, very well. They run to the ball very, very well. They're big up front and they're physical. The linebackers, do exactly what they're supposed to do. Their secondary is very athletic. And the one thing that I do notice is they rally to the ball and they get there pretty quick. So, we got to do a good job of getting on our blocks, sustaining our blocks, and, giving our backs opportunities to hit the hole and get vertical. And our receivers got to do a good job, just like they had the last couple weeks of blocking downfield. And, route running wise, they're going to play some zone covers. They might play some man, against us as well. But, we just got to do a good job and keep everything in front and not turn the ball over.
You kind of said it well after the game on Saturday. Still a lot to play for. You have two losses. Obviously a tough stretch coming up, the next two games against the two front runners in the league. But postseason, still very much a possibility if you can finish this thing strong.
It is. We just got to do the things that we need to do. It seems like we shoot ourselves in the foot a lot, and the most of it's just not playing, the full game and not taking advantage of opportunities and, putting ourselves in bad situations and when we don't need to do that. It seems like anytime something gets a little bit tight, we either get a penalty, throw an interception, not get a first down, or, give up a big play. We just got to overcome those things, be confident in our abilities and things that we can do, and understand that we're a very good football team. We just need to take care of business and do what we can do to win that ball game and not play to lose, play to win and battle each play.
Coach, as always, we appreciate the time. Have a great week of practice. Go get them. Looking forward to the game Saturday with Emporia State.
Thanks, Gerard.
That is head coach Chris Brown, coach of the Fort A State Tigers. Again, that'll be a 2 o'clock kick at Lewis Field, the Tigers and Hornets, with the Auto World pregame show getting underway at 1 on Tiger Radio Mix 103. Don't forget, if you missed any portion of the program, you can always catch it online at hayespost.com. And, of course, the video replay on Eagle Cable's Channel 14 and 614, Tuesdays and Wednesdays at 10:30 in the morning, and again at 7 o'clock at night. That's going to wrap up the program. It is brought to you once again by the Hayes Med Orthopedic Institute, the Taco Shop, Golden Belt Bank of Hayes and Ellis, G&L Automotive, Adams Brown, Barron and Ball, Couture for Men and Women, and Eagle Communications, and of course brought to you by the Golden Corral Buffet and Grill, just north of the interstate in Hayes. Golden Corral, best buffet in the USA. For Coach Chris Brown, this is Gerard Wildbrock. So long, everyone.
This is Gerard Welbrock inviting you to join us for Tiger Talk. Catch the video replay of Monday night's radio program at 10:30 and 7 o'clock Tuesdays and Wednesdays on Eagle Cable Channel 14 and 614. That's Tiger Talk, Mondays on Tiger Radio Mix 103 and Tuesdays and Wednesdays at 10:30 and 7 on Eagle Cable Channel 14 and 614.